The Lord didn't make it disappear for us to walk in the deepest things. He didn't make it complicated. And it was very simple for everyone to choose their own way. Do you believe that? Can you just do this out with everyone from? It's been an adventure that I can't even adequately express. One of the moments in my morning, I was just kind of waking up. I said, I heard a voice speak to me. And it said, there's a voice that I'm the other clock in the middle. So I heard a voice speak to me and it said, maybe I better get up and read that verse. And the verse that the Lord gave me, it talked to you at night, in sleep, or as you're waking up in your sleep, because you're not distracted at those times. It's like the Lord just found you and set it down and threw you in front of the Lord. Anybody would like to that? The Lord gave me this scripture. I know thy works, behold, I set before thee an open door, and no man can shut it. And you have a little strength, and have kept my word in my mouth. So, the Lord is telling me that he has set before us an open door, and it's kind of like this scripture that I said. We have a choice. The door is open. You know, one of the greatest things to me about this kingdom and being able to see the kingdom of the Spirit and follow the voice of the Spirit and walk in the Spirit is that it gives you insight in the place of the Father and know what's going on. So that we know how to live. You know, in the past, really concerned until we feel that burden lifts from us. the ministry that feels good to me said, am I bound just from him, or am I bound completely? That's what the Holy Spirit asked me. You know, that showed me something. The Lord was using that thing to train me. Because the Lord is telling you that you're ready to fulfill the Spirit in your flesh. You're seated in heaven, but just now this thing is asking you. Sounds like when the monument is asking Jesus, can you go into the bridge? Can you send us to the soul? Can you go into the bridge? And it shows you that the same authority that the Lord has given us. And so it says that you are bound to keep you from everything. And then that's what they have to do. But what began to happen is that as I was just at the time, the Holy Spirit says stop, and you pray and you go wrong. Now, if you think that you can be led by the Holy Spirit until he says that you are his Spirit, and maybe they say, now, do this with me, and maybe it's just a time that if you can do that, it's not a good Spirit. But I would do my prayer. In the middle of the night, I'll be back into the kitchen because I have a cast off on a circular path. So I'm just walking through the kitchen. I pray for the kitchen phone, and if it rains, I'll pick it up. And it'll be my son, so Dad, the phone is on. I say, yes, I am. He's got a cast off on the kitchen. And a couple of days later, walking to the kitchen at 2 o'clock in the morning, trying to get in and pick up Dad, you're praying for me, aren't you? See, even though he was in a bad situation, he was not working with Dad. Teaching him to remember the Christian message. And there is no difference in the Holy Spirit. The words you speak here have power on the other side of eternity. You have to know that. You're not insane if you speak the word of God or God. What he's telling you that. I remember once, and this happened over and over again. I remember once. Dad, you're praying for me, aren't you? He said, yes, I'm praying. He said, Dad, you're stirring up demons. I said, I know it. That's the whole point. You want to see the power of God in our flesh. Amen. Not just to be stirred up, but to be destined. That's my prayer. The Lord is first going to see it come to pass because the Lord is faithful. And through this whole journey, the Lord is going to be stirred up. But back home, it's been circumstances to bring him back to a place of safety. And I was silent, I was speaking. do take the pledge to Christ as the Holy Spirit. And so don't let anyone tell you any different. You can use places in God that anyone else can. It's not just to make this special for every day to use the providence. And so the Lord is teaching me this. And so I would pray for my daughter that I'm starting to get to help me out and see where I'm going to go to the place of God. And I'm starting to be like the same. And I'm like, maybe it's why would God do this? Why would God do this? Why does God not do this? And I had a friend of mine who said, brother, it's forcing me to go back to the third child. He said, how did he do that? So why did you go to sleep when you're not sick? Because he's God. He can do this. He can do anything he wants. We in our household, we have an abundance of signs from this miracle. It happens all the time. Every day. It's so over the top. There's a friend, some of my closest friends, But I look at it and say, nothing is like that when you come to and he would pour out to the level of, I think it has to be a level of maturity, so that you can get busy. And if you do get a little bit busy, then you do feel just like you did me. Because, I'm sharing my story pretty openly, and I've been rebuked many times, corrected many times, because this is a new life for me. And I wasn't used to coming into this and about the first place that my place Australia, I was not used to the whole dynamic of how people knew the power of God was to be able to know them because they didn't know how to do that. I remember he was sitting in a meeting and his friend John was speaking about this together for this place. And so he's telling me this, and he's telling me all these things that I've done, and how I feel right now, and what's coming up, and I thought, there's an adjustment that you see in the spirit of God that keeps you. So it would become normal life for you to move in the spirit of God. And God would teach you, and that's what he's trying to do. You know, my kids. He's moving my kids. And that's the end of God moving in the spirit of God. And so, I didn't even know this before. And he's also going to be in the spirit of God. And she came to me and she said, my son just tonight is getting called to go somewhere. We were putting him in the hospital. But we made the decision to travel. We were using the car for 5 hours to let him out. And we were getting the car to go, and we would look at each other and she said, my son would say, your parents are not. So they canceled their trip just because they knew that God didn't feel that he's going to run out of the trip. I mean, this time, I'm going to go to the hospital. me because that's supposed to be one of the parts of this. That's supposed to be what we want to do. Not Jesus is a Christian, but Jesus has a son of our lives. Everything. He's smiling, joyous, but the way you're telling me is this, you're willing to set aside the time to seek him. But I hope that there's a support that I do. By the word of your spirit, it helps you to meet and know who you are in Christ. Now I have that. As my eyes are clean, that we need to have vision to expand our ability to do this. And we're back to the question of how to say it. So you wonder, what in the world is this going to be? All kinds of stuff happens to me. I remember this story. I used to sit down in the city with this happening to get back to the world. And so I would go to bad schools. And I know the problems that happen to schools and businesses and stuff like that continually coming to me. And I'm telling you, I would walk to my father's and start at the school and show them how to do it. Anytime that you'd love to do something that is a blessing, chances are it's the Holy Spirit leading you in that direction. Because the flesh is telling you go to the street today and prove the price for 3 cents. That's what my flesh is telling me. And so, but you know, all of a sudden, so I started out at this point, and I went slowly around the map, through the map, and playing in tongues out loud, right? Because I'm playing in tongues out loud. So I'm playing in tongues out loud, but I make it all the way back to the starting point. And this time I even did bring some of the spirits, just a little bit. And so I did my prayer back again, speaking in tongues, singing in tongues, and this time it took 15 minutes. And so I did it again. So then I decided, okay, I took my prayer back to the outside, and I got my mind outside. It did not work. So I get outside, and so I'm thinking, but now I'm outside. I can use my outside tools. I can turn the light more aggressively. And you know what? Since there's not a lot of people walking outside anyway, I can even lift my hands. So I'll lift my hands and I'll do my prayer. And so, like I said, I didn't realize what took 10 minutes to do something. Walk around the entire structure reflecting on my thoughts. So I walked around the interior and I got back to the center. And of course, sometimes I notice that it takes a lot of people to see through. I've done it very well. So I'm standing at the edge of the street. And across the room, maybe, there's this really handsome young black man. And he's looking at me. He's looking at me like this. And so I'm thinking, maybe he's not looking at me. Maybe he is looking at me. And I'm trying to think, well, maybe it's from my wife, from my dad, who worked here. And so I'm coming to spend time with him. So, of course, you know, he gets up here and he sits down with me. And so what we're doing, I said, what we're doing is to sit down with him. And he says, my name is Jesus. And I said, I'm really a teacher. And so I'm scared that he speaks to you, and he speaks inside of you. He said, I'm the angel of this man. And so, I have spent that time finding the angel of this man. It's the fear step of faith, following the voice of the Spirit, and the things that have been manifested in the Spirit. And he said, now, I will thank you for being there, and for being there for my church. But, see, it's important to me. Because the kingdom of heaven is born. The Spirit man is born. And that's God. You know, I've been asked several times since then, and when you go back to it, I've never seen it before. But the phrase is that as you engage in the things of the kingdom, as you're taking the next steps of faith, and God honors you, that will bring you into the kingdom. And so, amen. And even our wisdom and understanding has a concern with this. God has a way to do it. That's the way of people. And then God can listen to explain and explain that God. He didn't make it disappear. He didn't use the right disappear of commands and speak to you and say, come on. It was very simple, biblical, simple steps. And so we have that wisdom to learn about this. Thank you. that this is for you and this is for you. So that's what you're saying.
I'm going to go to the next slide.
Thank you. danger, but there are life and death matters in life to me. If you are bound here, you need to be in the life and death. Remember, you got to prepare for it. The only one that is backing up the spirit of this chapter of kids, he's fighting people and looking at others. He's in the time to teach us. And I said, God, I'm so thankful. I said, my folks are coming to my point. I said, what's the point? I said, I'll pray. And I didn't pray a prayer. I didn't pray a prayer in the spirit. I just sort of asked the Lord about it. Thank you. Thank you.